get rid of this weather forecast and put it right in there.
Well, I wonder what Gertrude was so excited about. She called me last night and said, Julius, 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 I'm coming down to see you, see you, see you. And she should be here.
Julius, I'm here. Have I got it? Boy, I can't wait.
I know
wait,
you
Julius.
Have it.
Listen, I'll tell you. You know what's happening? You know what's happening right now? Do you know what's happening?
Yeah, Fred and Ethel are saying hi.
No, forget the pigs.
Hey, wait, I want to say hi to him.
Forget that, will you? Just forget the pigs! All right. Listen, I've got to tell you, Julius, you know what season's coming up?
Season. Summer. Summertime.
I know.
In the good old summertime. In the good old summertime.
No. Listen, I'll tell you what's coming. You know what happens in the summertime? I'll tell you what's happening in the summertime.
Ants come out in the summertime. Mosquitoes.
Forget all of that. Oh, no.
Okay. Well, tell me.
Now listen. All ready? Close your eyes.
Bumblebees.
No. No.
Okay, wait.
Are y'all ready?
That sounds like a boat.
Ah, you getting it?
You're going water skiing.
No, not water skiing.
What is it?
Hydroplaning, you know.
Hydroplaning?
Yeah, you know.
Oh, really? Yes, that's a very exciting sport.
It certainly is a wonderful
sport. And they're
going
to have the Gold Cup here, but that's in August.
I know, but you have to get ready for that, Julius. You have to get ready. And besides
that... How are you going to get ready?
How am I going to get ready? Do you know that there are no women hydroplane drivers?
Huh? Well, Pat O'Day is going to have a hydroplane driver.
Yes, I know. Yeah,
you're going to beat him to the punch?
Do you know I'm already Miss... I'm already Miss Pugetopolis, right?
Yes.
Okay. What about Miss Hydroplane Driver, huh? Would that be about that good?
You could call it mistake.
No, Judas, now forget about that. All I've got to do...
Listen, being a hydroplane driver requires a lot of skill. There are a lot of dangers involved. Experience. Do you have all of these attributes?
Got them all.
You bet. Well, as a matter of fact...
Uh-huh.
I have a nice surprise for you.
What's that?
I'm going to call Chip Hanauer, who drives the Squire shop boat.
Oh,
he's coming down on the
program. Good-looking devil.
Yes. He's going to come down and talk to you about being a hydroplane driver.
Why don't I talk to him?
Yeah, okay.
Give him some hints.
Well, while I'm doing that, let's take a minute out for these messages,
okay.
And then you're going to find out if you're qualified to be a hydroplane driver, okay?
Julius.
Watch this.
FM.
The Riverdale Rollers have been eating the same candy bars for years. Hey, Rollers, want to try a Twix candy bar?
Why? We've been eating the same candy bars for years.
But do they have a mix?
A what?
A mix. Rich milk chocolate.
We love chocolate!
Creamy caramel.
We love caramel.
And a delightful cookie crunch.
Crunch?
Yep, that's the mix.
Twix is delicious!
Twix cookie bars, the chocolate candy with the cookie crunch.
Delicious!
I'm Fruitsy Tootsie, I've got fruit on my hat. Fruit is sweet and juicy and it's great as a snack.
I'm an apple and I'm crunchy.
I'm banana, look at me.
I am strawberry.
I'm orange.
We've got minerals, we've got vitamin C.
I'm Fruitsy Tootsie, I've got fruit on my hat. Fresh fruit's fun for a snack.
Eat fruit as a snack.
Boy, I don't know if about you, Gertrude. I don't think you're really qualified to be a hydroplane driver.
Qualified, Judas? I've got all the qualifications in the world. I'm not frightened of any sort of...
Well, we'll find out. I just talked to Chip Hanauer, and he promised to be here.
Yes, he
should be here at any moment.
Ooh, that's probably him. Now, stand over here. I don't want you to frighten him. Come in.
Hi, JP.
Well, good morning, Chip.
How are you? What's it all about?
Well, boy, you look so terrific in your suit and everything.
I wear it all the time.
Is that the size of the boat?
Well, no, this is a model of the boat.
Oh, the model, okay.
But, this is the bathtub size. It's still got a little soap scum on it.
Chip, I want you to meet Gertrude.
Hi.
Gertrude.
Hi, Chip.
How are you?
How are you?
This is Chip Hanauer. Yeah. You know, Chip has been driving the Squire shop for...
Very good looking.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Well, listen, how long have you been driving the Squire Shop boat?
Well, the Squire Shop boat about 3 years, but I've been driving boats for about 14 years. I started driving boats when I was a little kid, so it's been a long time.
Well, you didn't start out in a big boat.
No,
like
we started in a little kids class for kids from 9 to 12 years old called J.
Uh-huh.
And there's a lot of racing here in the area, and you just kind of progress to bigger and bigger boats.
Okay. Did your dad drive a boat, or did he have a boat?
No, my father didn't. We had boats, but not so much race boats. And now he's very involved. Now he builds the turbine engines on the Pan Pack. Mm. So he started with me and built my boats. And
he's competing against you?
Yeah, for the first time in a long time, we race against each other. So
okay.
It makes it interesting.
Well, you know, you mentioned a whole Esmeralda there. Can I hold a boat here? Maybe you can tell us a little bit about it. You mentioned turbine. Does this particular boat have a turbine engine?
No, this particular boat has an aircraft engine. It's a very, very old aircraft engine that was used in World War II in the fighter planes. It's a 12-cylinder Rolls-Royce. Now, not the Rolls-Royce in a car, but during the war, they built aircraft engines.
I see. Now, what is this back here?
Okay, this is what we call a wing, and what it does is as the boat starts to rise up in the front like this, you don't want the boat to blow over backwards, of course, so as the boat starts to come up in the front, this wing starts to lift the back and levels the boat out again. So the boat's always trying to keep itself level and flying correctly.
How fast do you go in one of these?
About 180 or 185.
180, 185.
Oh, yeah. 185.
Have you ever been thrown out of a boat?
Yeah, in Pasco.
Thrown out of a boat.
In Eastern Washington a few years ago, I made a mistake and threw myself out on the deck and did a little damage to my leg. So it can happen.
Well, you know, I understand the first race was about a week ago in Florida. You weren't there.
No, we weren't there. Our boat's being redone and redesigned. It's going to look a little different than it does right here. And we're not ready yet. But
it's
we'll
a new
be,
boat, huh?
Well, close to a new boat. It's being rebuilt. And we'll be ready to run next week out here at Lake Washington for some test runs.
Really?
And,
next week, huh?
Yeah, we'd like to invite anybody down who'd like to come down. And
okay. You know, I have a nice surprise for you and for you, Gertrude.
Thank you, dear.
We are going to see Chip win a heat. This was last year's race.
This was last year, I think, in Seattle.
Okay, maybe this you can tell us a little bit about
this
it.
This is coming around. Well, you can see the bridge in the background. That's the north corner. Uh-huh. And this is coming across the start-finish line. And we run about five laps. Mm-hmm. I think this is one of the last laps or the last lap. And as you can see, those are blue skies for anybody who can't remember what those are.
All right.
And you can see how much air is under the boat, and the boat looks like it's bouncing around.
Yeah, but it's actually riding on the water rather than in the water.
Exactly. It doesn't what they call displace any water. It rides on a cushion of air. And you can see that the boat stays pretty level, and that's partly due to that wing that we talked about that keeps the boat, you know, in a proper
level
attitude.
Well, do all boats have the wings? I noticed like maybe a few years ago they had kind of like a rudder rather than a wing.
Those have changed now because there's more air under the boat. The boats didn't used to fly like they do now, and we've just recently gone to the wing to keep the boat stable and safe. The boats are actually a lot safer than they were in the old days. I think if the kids will remember from their watching in the old time, the boats really had a lot of accidents, and we've been very fortunate, and the sport's become a lot safer, and we really haven't injured anybody in quite some time.
Well, that's really fortunate, but you have been thrown out of the boat, and going at 180 miles an hour, your field of vision would be quite limited, wouldn't it?
Well, yeah, there's a lot of vibration, but it's funny. After you've been a race driver for so many years, things kind of slow down a little bit for
you. Experience, then, is really necessary.
Right, and
Did you hear that, Gertrude?
A lot of experience, and you know, growing up around the boats and working on the boats, and all those things really help out a lot. So,
now, when is the Gold Cup here in Seattle?
The Gold Cup, I think, is the second weekend in August, which is about a couple, 2 months away here. And that's the biggest prize in unlimited hydroplane racing. And it would be a very special day for me to be able to win the Gold Cup, and not only to win the Gold Cup, but to win it here at home in Seattle.
Wow, I think everyone would really be thrilled maybe to take it away from that fellow. I won't mention his name.
Yeah, that older fellow?
Yes, yeah. That fellow that
The shorter one.
Yeah.
Bill Mumsy. There, I said it.
Well, okay. Chip, I want to thank you very much for visiting us. What do you think, Gertrude?
Well, Julius, you know, it's so funny. I've got to get back to the phone department. Uh-huh. They need a little extra help, you know. Uh-huh. Okay, good. See you later.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thanks, dear. Have a nice day.
You thank you.
Well, Chip, we'll be looking for you to get the winning flag in many, many races this year. And congratulations for last year and your team and everything.
Thank you very much.
Okay, we'll be pulling for you.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, real good. It's cartoon time right now, and if we count to three, I think we'll see it. Or I think Mr. Lion is showing it somewhere. Where are you, Mr. Lion?